world.
Hey, puppy!
Hair dye. Come here. Come here. What kind of dog is that? I can't see it.
Poodle, I don't know.
Popcorn.
Potato. Left side.
And they had to go into the custer and get some tools enough to widen the passage to crawl through. But when they entered, they were pretty amazed by what they saw. Their first impression was that they were completely surrounded by jewels. What they were actually looking at were calcite crystals coating the walls. Looked a lot like these specimens you see here. So I guess you can imagine what they were thinking at the time. They thought they had struck it pretty rich. So the two brothers went into Custer and filed a mining claim called the Jewel Load. Now it didn't take them too long to realize that calcite crystal is basically too soft, has no monetary value at all. But the cowboys were still very fascinated by the cave system. So what they did was they traded in their mining claim.
Good morning, Joe Cave visitors. The 1140 scenic tour. We'll be leaving the visitor center shortly. If you're holding blue tickets marked 1140.
Particularly one in the, run by the National Park Service. Who can tell me what the number one rule is when you go into a cave?
Don't touch.
Now, the reason we don't want you to touch the walls in the cave is because we all have natural oils on our hands. With 85,000 people going through the cave each year, that oil can really start to discolor the limestone, even stop the formation growth on some of the wetter formations. And so that's why we ask that you don't touch when we're down in the cave. Some other rules is there's no eating, drinking, gum chewing or tobacco use in the cave, so if anyone has gum in their mouth, here's a garbage can here and a garbage can back there too. You need to get rid of that before we go down into the elevator. From today is that of a geologist. Is anyone here a geologist? Is there any geologists on the tour? It's often interesting when we do have a geologist because they can add something to what I have to say. hectic if there's ever two geologists, because they very rarely will agree. Why do you think a geologist might be fascinated with a cave? Why a cave might be a...
What is that smell? That is disgusting. Do you smell that, Jenny? That is gross.
Oh my god.
What is that stench?
Since we're looking at the cave from a geologist's perspective, you may be interested to know what the theory is as to how the cave was formed. I'll tell you. Jewel Cave is embedded in a limestone layer called Paha Sapa Limestone, a limestone layer that surrounds the Black Hills area. And there were cracks in the limestone. Those cracks got filled up with water. Now, when water and carbon dioxide combines, it forms a real mild acid called carbonic acid. And that might not mean a whole lot to some of you, unless you drink a lot of soda pop, because it's the same acid that you'll find in soda. If you took a piece of limestone and you put it into a glass of Coke, that limestone would start to dissolve. Well, they feel the cave was formed in that fashion, a slow dissolving action of the carbonic acid in the cracks, dissolving away the limestone, making up what we now have as Jewel Cave. A little different than some of the caves you might be familiar with that are possibly formed by running water, a mechanical erosion process. This was a chemical erosion process, a dissolving away of the limestone. That water then became supersaturated with calcite, and it began to deposit the calcite back on the cave walls. And that's what you can see here, is that calcite crystal coating, where it's broken off from the limestone base. About 5 or 6 inches of that nailhead spar, that calcite coating, is broken off from the limestone. An example of this would be if you've ever made rock candy and you take sugar and you add it to water. You keep adding it to the water till that water just becomes saturated with sugar. And then as the water cools, you can take a string and you can put it down into the water and sugar crystals will begin to crystallize on that piece of string. Well, that's sort of analogous as to what happened with the calcite crystal on the walls of the cave when the cave was completely filled in with water. Does anyone have any questions about the geology before we change our perspective? Yes.
Where'd the water go?
Right now the water table, which is a place in the ground where everything's saturated with water, or full of water, is below the deepest part in the cave. But they think that there have been a number of rises and falls in the water table throughout history.
How old is this?
The cave itself?
Exactly this section that we're in.
Well, they think it was formed in geologic time in the Mississippian time period, which... in geologic time is under 60 million years.
No one else can see the light bulb but me.
Uh-huh. You hear me stumble now.
Fraggle Rock. I'm slowly going blind in one eye from looking through this thing. Clouds.
Moving this way, get everyone down the the stairs that way.
Let's see here.
This part of the cave that we're going through right now was discovered by a husband and wife named Herb and Jan Kahn. When they started exploring in the late 1950s, the cave was about a mile long. When they finished exploring in 1980, the cave was 65 miles long. So they were really some of the pioneers of the exploration of Jewel Cave, and they discovered the part of the cave that we're going through today. The tour route that we're walking through today kind of gives you a bit of a false impression as to what the whole cave is like. They'll have the big passages like this one where you can walk for a quarter mile, but oftentimes in order to get to those passages, they have to do some difficult climbing or a belly crawl in order to get there. For example, to get to the unexplored area now in the southeastern part of the cave, the explorers have to go through a place called the Miseries. It's a quarter mile crawlway on their belly, one place as small as 7.5 inches tall. Another place called the Mini Miseries, where Jan Kahn would tell people as they went through the Mini Miseries to look to their left as they went through. Because on the left side there'd be some wet formations and some stalactites, and on the right side there'd just be a wall. Well, she'd tell them to look to the left when they went through, because once they got in there, it was so narrow that they couldn't turn their head at all. So those are some of the real tight squeezes that the explorers have to go through. As we continue to look at the cave from an explorer's perspective, look down the passages to the sides. Look down those little holes, or maybe they're just shadows, and ask yourself if you think there might be more cave if you go crawling into a hole like that. Also ask yourself if you think you'd fit through that, and that once you got into a little hole, if it happened to be a dead end, would you be able to come back out? Because those are some of the questions that the explorers have to ask themselves before they go crawling into a hole like that. Out on this finger here, that's where you'll be able to see the best. So if you can head out to the end of the finger on the platform, please.
I can't see it anymore.
We're looking at the cave from an explorer's perspective. You may be interested to know what the cave looks like when there aren't any explorers. So we're going to see the cave now by its natural lighting. That, of course, is dark. If you have any lights on your camcorders or on your cameras, you need to turn those lights off at this time. I'm pointing at a stalactite now with my flashlight. A stalactite hangs from the ceiling. As you may have learned at one time, at the bottom of a stalactite, you'll often find a stalagmite, and there's a stalagmite. When a stalactite and a stalagmite grow together, it forms a formation called a column. Here's an example of a column. This particular column is called a soda straw column, because it's hollow on the inside. As it's forming a stalactite, water runs down the middle and deposits a thin. Now that's not a soft formation, that's hard. Formed by water running down the side of the hill, depositing more minerals, mostly the mineral calcite, as it comes down. That's called flowstone. A formation similar to flowstone is a drapery. And here is a drapery, or several draperies. Draperies are formed by water running down the side of the wall, always at the same spot, depositing more calcite as it comes down. We'll be seeing a drapery along the tour route today called the Bacon Drapery. It's a 20-foot long drapery.
Gross. That was batteries are going dead.
He's obviously. Hi, we're in the middle of South Dakota, or on the side, over in a water park, and we're gonna go swimming.
Rapid City, no less.
Rapid City. And there's the water park.
Okay, I'm gonna go down a water slide, Dad.
Okay. Yeah.
Give me taking off my shoes.
There's one.
And the socks. There you go. Well, will I get a tan if I use sunscreen? Will I get a tan if I have sunscreen on?
I think you can get a tan in the morning and put sunscreen on in the afternoon.
What time is it?
The clock says 1:11.
It's 12.
12:11 in Rapid City time.
Okay. Well, why don't you go down the water slide with me?
I do.
Okay. Oh, Dad's coming with me. But she can't go in doubles.
Is this thing on? I don't know if this is on or not. Going kind of slow.
No, I didn't.
You have to leave.
Hey, Lori. Hi.
I'm going to get in and I'm going to walk under there.
No. Hey, Jenny and Idol. How do you zoom in on this?
Oh, it's way down there.
Oh, yeah.
Let's
Are you?
Hi.
Hi. Up and down.
Recording. Nigel, look at you. Sit up, Nigel. Look at his sexy body. He's got bubble legs.
His legs. Legs, feet.
Push the red button as soon as you're done.
Is that hurry up? Sitting down?
No. She's standing up, so she's like looking around like, you know. Looks like she's next. I can see her just saying, you can go before me. Oh, wow. Did you see that one?
Yeah, I heard it.
Totally airborne.
Oh,
totally.
She is. She's waving people on.
Oh, no.
Now she's talking to somebody. Oh, she's going to sit down. There she goes.
Oh, no.
Hello.
That was a definite. Is Andy next?
Yeah, Andy's next.
Did I leave the ground, or?
I don't think so. We'll see it in the movie.
Andy, you're supposed to put your feet together. Let's put your feet together.
No chance.
Thank you.
No, my sister's demon for that.
I got to get a...
Dakota.
You should be proud because
you know, this is actually longer than Grand Canyon. Oh, no doubt.
Is it?
Oh, heck yeah. Look at it.
I want to climb around.
Climb around. Yes. Oh, the Badlands are so awesome. This is our trip vacation to South Dakota.
1993, July.
After we get done vacationing in South Dakota, we'll go back to South Dakota where we live. Until we die.
They're like small, huge mountains. These are like the smallest mountains I've ever seen. Let's park the car and jump around. Don't put it on. It's impossible.
Brad, it's gorgeous. What show is that to?
Knight Rider. You know when they, at the beginning, when they show the cracks in the street like this?
Are you sure it wasn't the...
They show Knight Rider going, huh?
The helicopter.
Oh, you mean Airwolf? Yeah, I can see it. I don't know what...
I thought that was Airwolf.
Yeah, it is, I think. Maintaining a speed of 40 miles per hour, we speed through the Badlands.
Whoa.
Neat.
We're on the mesa. On the top of the mesa.
We're on the top of a mesa, Mom says. What are you doing?
Pulling off.
Ah, careful. These are a high dollar item.
Mommy and Dad.
What? There's been
Oh, cool.
Oh, funny.
Look at it, the bug.
I gotta take a picture of that.
But the ladybug was yellow. But it's that time.
I have a sunburn. Ow.
Did you see the arm in his head? He tried to fly.
In the sun.
Then come back.
Did you see the arm in his head?
Hey look, an antelope.
Zoom in. Close. Oh yeah. Ah! Okay.
Everybody get water. Nigel, you better get some water.
We're going to
dehydrate.
Don't get dehydrated. Then I'll come back and drink his pink grapefruit juice.
Okay, let's leave everything in here and lock the door and just take our cameras.
Because I just got him drinking tons of coffee.
You got your keys, honey?
Yeah, plenty of liquids in here.
Well, maybe I better put mine in my pocket.
What do you mean? How about it? I don't know. Badlands.